Hello and welcome to the session on National Curriculum Framework. The basic concerns of education to enable children to make sense of life and develop their potential, to define and pursue a purpose and recognize the right of others to do the same, stand uncontested and valid even today. If anything, we need to reiterate the mutual interdependence of humans, and as Tagore says, we achieve our greatest happiness when we realize ourselves through others. Equally, we need to reaffirm our commitment to the concept of equality within the landscape of cultural and socio-economic diversity from which children enter into the portals of the school. Individual aspirations in a competitive economy tend to reduce education to being an instrument of material success. The perception which places the individual in exclusively competitive relationships puts unreasonable stress on children and thus distorts values. It also makes learning from each other a matter of little consequence. Education must be able to promote values that foster peace, humaneness and tolerance in a multicultural society. Curriculum is one of the important aspects of an educational system. Curriculum development requires a creative and innovative vision to foresee and plan to meet the existing needs. It should provide a comprehensive view of the social and political context of the society and system of education. Curriculum embraces all the activities that children experience as learners in the school. According to the Secondary Education Commission, curriculum does not mean only the academic subjects traditionally taught in the school, but it includes the totality of experiences that a pupil receives through the manifold activities that go in the school, in the classroom, library, laboratory, workshop, playground, and in the numerous informal contacts between the teachers and the pupils. An important development in the field of school education during the past 4 decades has been the professionalization of curriculum development, syllabus design, and the preparation of instructional materials including textbooks and their evaluation. In fact, curriculum development, which is at the root of renewal process, has to be seen as a permanent search for qualitative improvement of education in response to various changes in the society. A meaningful curriculum shall have to be responsive to the socio-cultural context of the country. Ever since the National Policy on Education was approved by the Parliament in 1986, efforts to redesign the curriculum have been focused on the creation of a national education system capable of responding to India's diversity of geographical and cultural milieus, while ensuring a common core of values along with academic component. Thus, the NEP recommended a common core component in the school curriculum throughout the country. A number of factors called for changes in curriculum. Since education is regarded as an investment, changes are considered necessary for the development of the society. Addition of new subjects and omission of the old are felt necessary in the curriculum. Technological changes tend to change values and norms of the society, which exercise pressure for change of curriculum. Even the social and moral values of the society have their effects on curriculum development. Political and academic factors of the country also influence the same. National Curriculum Framework. National Curriculum Framework seeks to provide a framework within which teachers and schools can choose and plan experiences that they think children should have. In order to realize educational objectives, the curriculum should be conceptualized as a structure that articulates required experiences. The responsibility of formulating the National Curriculum Framework or NCF lies with the National Council of Educational Research and Training, NCERT as a means of establishing national standards. Curriculum designing has a special place among the diverse responsibilities envisaged in the Charter of NCERT. The NEP entrusted NCERT with the responsibility of developing the national curriculum framework and reviewing it at frequent intervals. The NEP of 1986 has made it clear that the national system of education would be based on a national curricular framework which contains a common core along with other components that are flexible. This culminated in the National Curriculum for Elementary and Secondary Education, a framework 1988. It was the first document detailing a national curricular framework in schools. The pedagogical issues highlighted in the NPE 1986 were also adequately reflected in the 1988 curriculum framework. Emphasis was also laid on continuous and comprehensive evaluation as well as on utilization of media and educational technology. In addition to these, realization of the goals enshrined in the Indian Constitution was one of the major objectives of the 1988 curriculum. The curriculum framework prepared at the central level provides a broad overview of the school curriculum, including general objectives, subject wise objectives, suggested schemes of studies and guidelines for the transaction of the curriculum and evaluation of people's outcomes. Subsequent NCF was published in 2000. In July 2004, a meeting was held to revise the National Curriculum Framework. Subsequent to this meeting, a letter from Education Secretary to the Director NCERT reiterated the necessity to review the National Curriculum Framework for School Education or NCFSC 2000 in the light of the report Learning Without Burden of 1993. In the context of these decisions, a national steering committee chaired by Professor Yashpal and 21 national focus groups were set up. Membership of these committees included representatives of institutions of advanced learning, NCERT's own faculty, school teachers, and non-governmental organizations. Consultations were held in all parts of the country, in addition to 5 major regional seminars held at the NCERT's Regional Institute of Education in Mysore, Ajmer, Bhopal, Bhubaneswar, and Shillong. Consultations with state secretaries, SERTs, and examination boards were carried out. A national conference of rural teachers was organized to seek their advice. Advertisements were issued in national and regional newspapers inviting public opinion, and a large number of responses were received. The revised National Curriculum Framework or NCF opens with a quotation from Rabindranath Tagore's essay Civilization and Progress, in which the poet reminds us that a creative spirit and generous joy are key in childhood, both of which can be distorted by an unthinking adult world. The opening chapter discusses curricular reform efforts made since independence. The National Policy on Education or NPE 1986 proposed the National Curriculum Framework as a means of evolving a national system of education, recommending a core component derived from the vision of national development enshrined in the Constitution. The Program of Action or POA 1992 elaborated this focus by emphasizing relevance, flexibility, and quality. Main characteristics of the National Curriculum Framework. The National Curriculum Framework defines core education values, educational goals, principles and goals of educational areas, principles of evaluation of student achievements, and principles of evaluation and self-evaluation of the implementation of the national curriculum. It is important to point out that the National Curriculum Framework is an exceptionally significant document for planning and organizing school operations, including the preparation of the school curriculum. The curriculum should aim at preparing a child for life, which means that relevant knowledge should be imparted and appropriate skills, competencies, and values developed. The fact that learning has become a source of burden and stress on children and their parents is an evidence of a deep distortion in educational aims and quality. To correct this distortion, the NCF proposed 5 guiding principles for curriculum development: connecting knowledge to life outside the school, ensuring that learning shifts away from rote methods, enriching the curriculum so that it goes beyond textbooks, making examinations more flexible and integrating them with classroom life, nurturing an overriding identity informed by caring concerns within the democratic polity of the country. The main features of NCF are the following: undifferentiated curriculum. Every child and every student has a right to his or her highest educational development. The National Curriculum Framework stresses on common curriculum for all children irrespective of caste, creed, sex and place of birth. The specific needs of the disadvantaged group of the society also ought to be met through the curriculum. General education. The National Curriculum envisages the first 10 years of school as the period of general education. A diversified curriculum should be introduced at the end of general education, which provides the children with the opportunity to receive instruction in each of the areas necessary for their overall development. Common core elements. The NCF recommended some compulsory core elements to be taught in the country, which aimed at developing the national identity and spirit of togetherness. It was for the first time that conscious effort had been made to place values in the system of education in the country. The common core will include the following core elements: the history of India's freedom struggle, common cultural heritage of India, democracy, secularism, socialism, gender equality, environmental conservation, constitutional obligations, removal of social barriers, family norms, development of scientific approach, etc., and other content essential to nurture national identity. Education regarding India's cultural heritage should be imparted to students in order to develop national identity and a spirit of togetherness. These elements will cut across subject areas and will be designed to promote values such as India's common cultural heritage, egalitarianism, democracy and secularism, equality of sexes, protection of environment, removal of social barriers, observance of small family norm and inculcation of scientific temper. All educational programs will be carried out in strict conformity with secular values. India has always worked for peace and understanding between nations, treating the whole world as one family. True to this Hoyri tradition, education has to strengthen this world view and motivate the younger generations for international cooperation and peaceful coexistence. This aspect cannot be neglected. To promote equality, it will be necessary to provide for equal opportunity for all, not only in access but also in the conditions of success. Besides, awareness of the inherent equality of all will be created through the core curriculum. The purpose is to remove prejudices and complexes transmitted through the social environment and the accident of birth. Value education. The NCF has envisaged that value education should permit all aspects of school life and should be integrated into the curriculum areas. In view of erosion of values, it is imperative through the curriculum to inculcate moral and social values amongst students. Examination reforms. Examination reforms constitute the most important systematic measure to be taken for curricular renewal and to find a remedy for the growing problem of psychological pressure that children and their parents feel, especially in classes 10th and 12th. The NCF recommended that evaluation should be treated as an integral part of the classroom teaching or learning process. Specific measures include changing the typology of the question paper so that reasoning and creative abilities replace memorization as the basis of evaluation, and integration of examinations with the classroom life by encouraging transparency and internal assessment. Other features. In all the four familiar areas of the school curriculum, that is language, mathematics, science and social sciences, significant changes are recommended with a view to making education more relevant to the present day and future needs, and in order to alleviate the stress with which children are coping today. This NCF recommends the softening of subject boundaries so that children can get a taste of integrated knowledge and the joy of understanding. In addition, plurality of textbooks and other material which could incorporate local knowledge and traditional skills, and a stimulating school environment that responds to the child's home and community environment are also suggested. In language, a renewed attempt to implement the three language formula is suggested, along with an emphasis on the recognition of children's mother tongues, including tribal languages, as the best medium of education. The NCF draws attention to four other curricular areas, namely work, the arts and heritage crafts, health and physical education, and peace. In the context of work, certain radical steps to link learning with work from the pre-primary stage upwards are suggested, on the ground that work transforms knowledge into experience and generates important personal and social values such as self-reliance, creativity, and cooperation. Finally, the document recommended partnerships between the school system and other civil society groups, including non-governmental organizations and teacher organizations. Conclusion. The implication of globalization for societies around the world is at the heart of present concerns to improve and upgrade education systems. The development and reform of educational curriculum is an ongoing preoccupation for education authorities in all countries. Efforts have been made by the government of these countries to provide all citizens with access to quality education at least at the basic level, while improving and widening access to secondary and higher education. The meaning and role of education, of teaching and learning, are constantly being redefined. The existing curriculum is increasingly being called into account as people leave the school ill prepared for the world of work. Designing a curriculum is a national concern mainly shared between educational protagonists at the center, local and school level. The term national curriculum framework is often wrongly construed to mean that an instrument of uniformity is being proposed. The intention, as articulated in the NPE 1986 and the Program of Action 1992, was quite the contrary. NPE proposed a national framework for curriculum as a means of evolving a national system of education capable of responding to India's diversity of geographical and cultural milieus. All the groups in India have equal rights to coexist and flourish. The education system needs to respond to this cultural pluralism inherent in our society. To strengthen our cultural heritage and national identity, the curriculum should enable the younger generation to reinterpret and reevaluate the past with reference to new priorities and emerging outlooks of a changing societal context. The education system does not function in isolation from the society of which it is a part. Hierarchies of caste, economic status and gender relations, cultural diversity, as well as the uneven economic development that characterize Indian society deeply influence access to education and participation of children in school. The social context of education in India thus presents a number of challenges which must be addressed by the curriculum framework both in its design as well as its implementation. This framework for curriculum presents a vision of what is desirable for our children. It seeks to enable those who are involved with the children and their schooling with the basis on which they can make choices that determine the curriculum. This provides an understanding of issues relating to children's learning, the nature of knowledge, and the school as an institution. This approach to the curriculum draws attention to the importance of the school ethos and culture, the classroom practices of teachers, learning sites outside the school, and learning resources, as much as to the dimensions of the system that exert direct and indirect influence. The designing of large-scale curricular interventions, key activities such as the preparation of syllabus and textbooks in examination reform must be consistent with each other and with educational aims for progress and improvement in the quality of education that we provide to our children. Let us summarize what we have discussed so far. The National Policy of Education 1968 aimed to promote national progress, a sense of common citizenship and culture, and to strengthen national integration. After the adoption of 1968 policy, there had been considerable expansion in educational facilities all over the country at all levels. Curriculum is one of the important aspects of an education system. Curriculum development requires a creative and innovative vision to foresee and plan to meet the existing needs. It should provide a comprehensive view of the social and political context of the society and system of education. Ever since the National Policy on Education was approved by the Parliament in 1986, efforts to redesign the curriculum have been focused on the creation of a national educational system capable of responding to India's diversity of geographical and cultural milieus while ensuring a common core of values along with academic component. Thus, the NEP recommended a common core component in the school curriculum throughout the country. This led to the formulation of the National Curriculum Framework, or NCF. The chapter in detail discusses NCF and its importance in the education system of India. Now, you can try to answer the questions given here. What led to the formulation of National Curriculum Framework 2005? What are the main characteristics of NCF 2005? What are the special recommendations of NCF on examination reforms? What are the 10 core components of curriculum as mentioned in the NCF? Now, you can go through the reference books for further reading. Modern Trends in Indian Education, written by Jagannath Mohanty and published by Deep and Deep Publications Private Limited, New Delhi, in the year 2004. Education in India, Problems and Perspectives, written by Dash M and published by Atlantic Publishers and Distributors, New Delhi, in 2004. Globalization and Living Together, written by Rao DB and published by Discovery Publishing House, New Delhi, in 2005. Contending Historical Identities in India, written by Nair D, published in Journal of Educational Media, Memory and Society, Volume 1, pages 145 to 164 in Jester, 2009. National Curriculum Framework 2005, published by National Council of Education Research and Training, New Delhi, in 2005. Thank you for watching this program. We can meet again with another topic. Have a nice day.